These Iowa residents are getting a new home in East Texas.
We received 31 birds today from Iowa, and those birds will be going out to the Angelina National Forest. Any of these birds that come into Texas from out of state, we draw blood for disease testing.
We need to stop.
We've been really lucky, have really healthy birds coming in. In addition to that, the University of Georgia is doing DNA on all these birds.
Keeping track of their kind of pedigree, just like dogs.
Each bird is banded with their own ID.
45466.
And will become part of a restocking effort that has been taking place for more than 40 years.
Turkeys were historically found throughout close to 30 million acres in East Texas. So this is part of their historic range. Around the turn of the 20th century, we lost birds due to overharvest primarily. European settlers coming into Texas, there were no regulations to stop them from harvesting those animals and no law enforcement out there to enforce the few regulations that we did have.
The eastern wild turkey was nearly wiped out due to habitat loss and unregulated hunting. With new laws in place, a plan was put in motion to bring the eastern turkey back to Texas.
The early efforts began with wild trapped eastern turkeys in 1979. Dr. Roel Lopez coined the phrase superstocking.
See you in Texas.
He said if we put large numbers of birds on the ground, up to about 70 to 80 birds, that even under the worst case scenario, you'd have a really good opportunity for success, as long as you're focusing on quality habitat.
Everybody ready? First group, let's go ahead, open that second flap, dump them, let them go.
Now, in addition to restocking turkeys, biologists are trying to find out what habitat helps turkeys thrive.
Texas Parks and Wildlife was looking for a group to study the effect of prescribed fire on the reproduction of eastern wild turkeys. And so we're out here studying the movement and the reproduction period of these birds.
The students will be able to track the birds outfitted with GPS transmitters and look at where they nest versus where they forage for food.
You know, are they using a first year burn? Are they using a second year burn? Or how are they using it? Using with Google Earth, we can animate that and kind of show you what the toms are doing and what the hens are doing.
This latest release meets the super stocking quota for the study.
I'm excited that we now have all 80 of the birds for the study on the ground. And so essentially we're just going to be looking at the movement behavior. We'll start doing vegetation sampling at each nest site, and then that'll go into this first year's worth of data, and then we'll come back and do it again next year.
Since 1979, more than 7,500 eastern turkeys have been released into 56 counties in East Texas on wildlife management areas, private lands, and national forests.
Well, from what we can tell, the birds appear to be doing pretty well. We have some of our highest populations of turkeys in East Texas on that side. So we know that it can be very successful.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Wildlife Restoration Program.